So today we're going to chat about 10 mistakes you would want to avoid when defending your thesis or your dissertation. Mistake number one, not asking for clarifications when the question is unclear. This is a mistake I myself made some years ago when I defended my own doctoral thesis. The questioner asked a question, and I'm sure it was a very good question, but I didn't really get it because it was a long and complicated question and he spoke really fast. So the question was not completely clear to me. But because I was nervous, because I was a bit intimidated by the seriousness and the formality of the situation, for whatever reason, I didn't ask for clarifications. The natural and logical and obvious thing for me to do should have been to ask for clarification, but I didn't. And that was a mistake. So don't you make my mistake. If the questioner's question is not completely clear to you, politely ask for clarifications. Say something like, "My apologies, but I'm afraid I didn't quite catch the essence of your question. Can you please help me better understand what you meant when you said this or that?" Don't be afraid. If the question is unclear, politely ask for clarification. Mistake number two, cutting the question off. Well, don't cut off the question. Don't interrupt the questioner. Let him finish their question, regardless whether or not you expected that question, regardless whether or not you know the answer to that question, at least let him finish asking their question. Don't cut him off. It's a bit rude and disrespectful, so don't do it. Plus, let them speak. They will feel important when they talk, so let them. And, as some would argue, the more time they spend talking, the better it is, because they are using up all the time, so you get fewer questions to deal with. So in general, I'd say, don't interrupt the questioner. Let them talk. Let them finish their question, and then answer it. Mistake number three, pretending to know the answer when you don't. If the question is indeed unexpected, it is a difficult question, something we did not prepare for, and something to which we cannot come up with a good answer on the spot, my suggestion is, be honest. Don't pretend to know the answer when you don't. This is something I also talked about in one of my previous videos concerning thesis defense. I'll link it up. My suggestion is this. It is very likely that there are going to be some questions that we can't answer because we can't prepare for all possible questions and have answers to all of them. So, have something prepared for when you are confronted with a question that you truly don't know how to answer. Have a polite response prepared so that you know you have something to say, something to rely on. In general, I would say don't pretend to know the answer when you don't. Because whatever fake answer we come up with, most likely it is a bad answer anyway. It is the wrong answer anyway. And the professors will know that you don't know the correct answer and you are just wasting everybody's time. So don't do that. Be honest. Sometimes in a defense, honesty can be impressive, because being honest shows courage. Mistake number four, being arrogant. We want to be confident, of course. We want to be as confident as we can possibly be, but we do not want to be arrogant. We do not want to overdo it. What I often see is this, in trying to be confident, in trying to deal with one's nervousness, one overdoes it. In trying to suppress one's nervousness, they somehow become overconfident to the point of being arrogant and unpleasant. Look, this might depend a little bit on the culture, but in general, people know that a thesis defense is a bit of a scary situation, especially if it is a good and reputable university that does things very seriously and very formally, with multiple professors on the panel and with a public audience in the auditorium. In such a situation, it is understandable and even expected that the student or the candidate is a little bit nervous, a bit tense, perhaps a little bit intimidated as well. So nobody's going to fail you just because you're a little bit nervous, because you are supposed to be nervous. Don't let your nervousness somehow propel you into being arrogant, or disrespectful, or making too many silly jokes, or being over the top defensive and constantly disagreeing with whatever the questioner says. It is a formal and serious situation, so be serious, be formal. It is natural and good to be a little bit nervous, because it shows that we are taking this very seriously. Don't be arrogant. At least, I don't quite like it. Arrogance doesn't impress me. Most of the people that I know who are very arrogant are usually hiding some sort of insecurity or shortcoming. Mistake number five, rambling on and on. Have a clear structure in your answer and try to be concise. Thank you for the question. It's a very good question. In response, there are three aspects that come to mind. Firstly, secondly, finally. Does that address your question? Thank you. Even if some of the substance of this answer might be a little bit vague, but I'd still consider this a good response overall because it is a clear, structured, and concise answer. I would appreciate that. Mistake number six, talking too fast or too slowly. I don't know which one is worse, too fast or too slow. I certainly made the mistake of talking too fast. Now, years later, when I watch my own doctoral defense, I'm like, why did I have to talk so fast? My answers would have sounded so much better, and I would have come across as so much calmer had I talked a little bit more slowly. Now, of course, nervousness has something to do with it. I was tense, I was a bit nervous, I was also very eager, I was also younger. So I think the professors on the panel got that. I think they understood that I was a bit nervous, I was very eager, and I was trying very hard. I don't believe they held that against me. I think overall my defense went just fine. But if I could do my doctoral defense again, I'd talk more slowly. So this is not a huge deal. Mistake number 6 is not the biggest mistake one can make, but since I feel like I made this mistake, it's worth mentioning. Mistake number 7, rushing yourself before the defense. In general, we know that thesis defense is a tense and serious situation where one tends to be nervous. So, give yourself plenty of time prior to the defense to get ready. Don't rush yourself. Get everything ready and in order ahead of time. In this way, right before the defense, you can take some time to just relax, calm down, and put yourself in the right state of mind. Don't rush yourself before the defense. Mistake number 8, not knowing the protocols, the format, and the panel. So the point here is that we want to avoid surprises. We want to know what's going to happen. Most universities publish some kind of protocol for thesis defenses, outlining and describing what's going to happen in the defense, what the format or procedure will be, and which professors will be on the panel. It is a mistake when these protocols are there, but we don't familiarize ourselves with them. So read the protocols, attend a few thesis defenses prior to your own, and research the background of the professors on your panel. In this way, we're a bit better prepared for what might happen during the thesis defense. Mistake number 9, assuming that you know everything about your thesis. This is a natural assumption to make. After all, I am the one who wrote the thesis, I'm the one who conducted the research, so I know everything about it. Well, that might not be the case. We might know some aspects of our thesis really, really well, but some other aspects of the thesis which we did a while back, we might have forgotten already. So, give your thesis a very thorough read before the defense. Do a couple of mock defenses with your friends. See what questions they might come up with concerning your thesis. Don't make the mistake of assuming that we know everything about our own thesis. Mistake number 10, thinking you will be unnatural at this. Some students say, oh, I don't really need to prepare for this, I don't want to over-rehearse, I'll be a natural at this. I just need to show up, be spontaneous, and be myself, I'll do great. Well, maybe you will. Maybe you are among the few who truly are, by nature, very good at this. But my opinion is, and my experiences have been, for most people, and just like most things in life, practice makes perfect. So preparation is important. Doing some mock defenses and dressed rehearsals is important. Don't assume I'll be a natural at this and I don't need to prepare. You probably do need to prepare. So how should I prepare? Well, it is a very good thing that you are watching this video of mine. Now go watch the other videos I have on the topic of thesis defense, then you'll be good to go. So, success with all your preparations, have a great defense, and most importantly, try to enjoy it.